Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ, and a most warm welcome to all of you joining us today. We're coming to you live from St. Peter's Square, and shortly Pope Francis will be presented at the window, and we will hear a brief message on this second Sunday of Lent, and we will together recite the traditional Angelus prayer. From wherever you're joining us, I'd like to welcome all of you to this live broadcast. We know some of you tuning in through our own Vatican media channels, through the Vatican Audio Live Events app or the Vatican Radio app, our Vatican News English web portal, YouTube channel, or Facebook Live feed. I'd like to also welcome those of you joining us on television, some through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, Salt and Light Media, EWTN, Shalom World Television Networks, Shalom TV at Medar Shan TV, and to those of you joining through radio, some through Radio Maria in England, some through Luminous Radio, we have others tuning in through other local or diocesan radio stations or our shortwave radio signal. And to those of you who may be joining through other internet sites around the world, welcome to you all on this second Sunday of Lent. This past week, Pope Francis made his annual spiritual exercises. Generally, the entire Curia gathers for the spiritual exercises during the first full week of Lent. This year, they were encouraged to spend that time in reflection, even though there was no specific person guiding their reflections. And Pope Francis picked up his activities yesterday. So we're here now waiting along with all of these people. We see now the window where Pope Francis will soon join us. We see some Burkina Faso flags here on the left of the screen. They're here today to express their gratitude to Pope Francis for the appeal he made last week regarding the terrorist attacks that continue to take place in that country. The so-called Islamic State group claimed responsibility for killing over 70 soldiers, wounding dozens others, and taking others hostage. And our Holy Father expressed his concern for that last week. Our Holy Father now coming to the window, being greeted by those who are present in the square. And we now await his words.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good day. On the second Sunday of Lent, the Gospel of the Transfiguration is proclaimed. Jesus takes Peter, James, and John with him on the mountain and is revealed to them in all his beauty as Son of God. Let us pause a moment over this scene and ask ourselves, of what does this beauty consist? What do the disciples see? A special effect? No, that's not it. They see the light of God's holiness shining on the face and on the clothing of Jesus, the perfect image of the Father. They're seeing God's majesty, his beauty, but God is love. And so the disciples beheld with their eyes the beauty and splendor of divine love incarnate in Christ. It's a foretaste of paradise. What a surprise for the disciples. They had the face of love before their very eyes for so long without ever being aware of how beautiful it was. Only now did they realize it, with so much joy, with immense joy. In reality, through this experience, Jesus is forming them, preparing them for an even more important step. Soon after that, in fact, they would have to recognize the same beauty in him when he would mount the cross, and his face would be disfigured. Peter struggles to understand. He would like to stop time, pause the scene, stay there, and prolong this marvelous experience, but Jesus does not allow it. Indeed, his light cannot be reduced to a magical moment. That's something else. It would thus become something false, artificial, something that would dissolve into the fog of passing sentiment. On the contrary, Christ is the light that orients our journey like the pillar of fire for the people in the wilderness. Jesus' beauty does not alienate his disciples from the reality of life, but gives them the strength to follow him all the way to Jerusalem, all the way to cross. The beauty of Christ is not alienating. It always brings us forward. It doesn't make you hide, but it helps you go forward. Brothers and sisters, this gospel traces a path for us too. It teaches us how important it is to remain with Jesus, to stay with Jesus, even when it is not easy to understand everything he says and does for us. In fact, it is by staying with him that we learn to recognize on his face the luminous beauty of love he gives us, even when it bears the marks of the cross. And it is in his school that we learn to see the same beauty on the faces of the people who walk beside us every day. Family, friends, colleagues, who take care of us in the most varied ways. How many luminous faces, how many smiles, how many wrinkles, how many tears and scars reveal love around us. Let us learn to recognize them and to fill our hearts with them. And then let us set out in order to bring the light we have received to others as well through concrete acts of love, diving into our daily occupations more generously, loving, serving, and forgiving with greater earnestness and willingness. The contemplation of God's wonders, the contemplation of God's face, of the Lord's face, should bring us forward in serving the others. We can ask ourselves, do we know how to recognize the light of God's love in our lives? Do we recognize it with joy and gratitude on the faces of the people who love us? Do we look around us for the signs of this light that fill our hearts and open our hearts to love and service, or do we prefer the straw fires of idols that alienate us and close us in on ourselves? The great light of the Lord and the artificial light of idols, what do I prefer? May Mary, who kept the light of her Son in her heart, even in the darkness of Calvary, accompany us always on the way of love.
Et concepit de Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
E verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut digni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Grazie a Tua, questum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che ange renunziante, Christi Fili Tui, incarnazione coniovimu, per passione meius ad crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus et fontis requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, in these days, my thought often goes to the victims of the train accident in Greece. Many were young students. I pray for those who are deceased, those who are close to them, their relatives. May the Madonna comfort them. I express now my sorrow for the tragedy in the waters of Cutro near Crotone. I pray for the numerous victims of the shipwreck, for their relatives, and for those who survived. I manifest my appreciation and my gratitude to the local population and the institutions providing solidarity and welcome to these our brothers and sisters. And I renew my appeal to everyone that similar tragedies are not repeated. Those who traffic in human persons, may they be stopped. The voyage of hope should never become a voyage of death. The clear waters of the aqua of the water, may it never be bloodied more for these accidents. May God give us the strength to understand and to cry, to weep.
Saluto tutti voi.
I greet all of you, people from Rome and pilgrims from Italy and from various countries. In particular, I greet the Ukrainian community of Milan who've come for the fourth centenary of the martyrdom of Bishop Josaphat, who gave his life for the unity of Christians. And he's encouraging them to welcome their those from Ukraine, to welcome them as they flee. I greet the pilgrims from Lithuania, as well as the Lithuanian community of Rome, who celebrate St. Casimir, as well as the Catholic community from Saragossa in Spain, parish groups who've come. And he mentioned two places in Spain. I'm from Tbilisi in Georgia. I greet the faithful from Burkina Faso and the candidates of confirmation from two places. And he's mentioning other places where people have come from in the area of Rome. I wish all of you a good Sunday. Please do not forget to pray for me.
Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
Enjoy your meal and arrivederci. We'll see each other again, his famous sign-off, signature sign-off. So this now brings an end to the live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis here in St. Peter's Square on this second Sunday of Lent. I invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus and other Vatican and world news. We will be back again live on Wednesday when the Holy Father will once again lead the general audience. On behalf of Vatican Media, I'd like to thank our in-studio audio technician, Adriano Vitali, and our coordinator, Thaddeus Jones, as well as all the media partners who've brought this broadcast to you: Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, Salt and Light Media, EWTN, Shalom TV, Et Midrashan TV, Radio Maria.